Welcome to the Codependency Inside Out Podcast with your host, counselor and trauma recovery coach, AJ Mahari. This podcast will explain and examine codependency's many traits and painful relational challenges and why you need a healthy relationship to and with yourself, as well as why it's important to get into a healing and recovery process. Please visit ajmahari.ca to purchase and book sessions with AJ Mahari.
Welcome to Codependency Inside Out. There's a lot to talk about when it comes to codependency, for sure. And I have 32 years experience helping people with codependency to recover from codependency. And often the relationships that people with codependency encounter, people often with cluster B personality disorders, not always, but often. And that's how people often find out that and realize that they have codependency. So here we start off with the reality that many mental health professionals today are, again or still, depending on one's perspective, I'm not sure which it is. It could be, it's different all over the map. But the question can begin when you research this, like so. What is a codependent personality disorder?
Why are some people and some mental health professionals saying codependent personality and others certainly aren't? And there's everything in between. So that'll be coming to the podcast soon.
Because is codependency a personality disorder? Well, it was proposed to DSM-3 in the mid-80s as codependent personality disorder. But it was not put into the DSM, Diagnostic Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders of the American Psychiatric Association. So at this point in time, I believe it's pretty erroneous or not really helpful to pathologize codependency by saying it's codependent personality disorder. So when I say that, please do understand codependency is seen today as a mental health challenge. It is formidable. It is painful. It interferes with relationships. It is a result of family of origin, adverse childhood experience that needs to be explored and healed. And that's very different for many people with codependency. But codependency, people can have the way that I describe it. They can have it moderately, significantly, or severely. Codependency has been somewhat left in limbo land of interpretation. And in some ways that's helpful, in other ways it's probably not helpful. So, but at this point in time, it is not officially a personality disorder, and I think that that's probably a positive thing. So originally the term codependent described people living with or in relationships with an addicted person. But that has long since passed. That could still be a situation that somebody with codependency is in or part of the adverse childhood experience, but it's not limited to that as it was once thought to be. And modern understandings of codependency now refer to a specific relationship, sometimes addiction, but a specific relationship addiction characterized by a preoccupation and extreme dependence, emotional, social, and sometimes physical, on another person. The only thing that I would say along with that is not everybody with codependency has relationship addiction. Not everybody with codependency has love addiction. Is love addiction the same thing as relationship addiction? That we will get into further. But it is not the case for everybody with codependency that they have either relationship addiction or love addiction, or if those two things in fact go together. We shall see. The concept of codependency does still apply to families with substance abuse issues, but it's used also to refer to other situations as well. The main consequence of codependency is that people with codependency are usually, more often than not, busy taking care of others, forget to take care of themselves, and that results in a disturbance of identity development. And that's according to Knutson and Terrell in 2012. So in 1986, a psychiatrist argued that codependency should be defined in the next edition of the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, DSM, which was 3, borrowing diagnostic criteria from alcohol dependence, dependent personality disorder, and borderline personality disorder, histrionic personality disorder, and even post-traumatic stress disorder is what this psychiatrist was kind of taking from and seeing codependency as a personality disorder, incorporating traits of these other disorders. But the American Psychiatric Association and the working group that writes the DSM, each edition, did not accept codependent personality disorder as a diagnosis, did not include codependent personality disorder in the DSM. And even right now with DSM-5, codependency is still not codependent personality disorder at all in the DSM. So a little bit still in a limbo place, but I don't think that personality constructs are overly helpful. And also, they're often about adverse childhood experience responses, and it's a humanistic view of said, but I really think that codependency does not need the pathologizing of getting any kind of descriptor of being a personality disorder. Though I will go over that one more time separately. So this argument was unsuccessful by the psychiatrist in the mid-80s to put codependent personality disorder in DSM-3R and the next revision, and it did not include codependency as a personality disorder, as I just said. So DSM-5, the newest edition, still only refers to dependent personality disorder, not codependency. Codependency does not only overlap, so it overlaps with dependent personality disorder, but also with borderline personality disorder, which is the one reason some research has dismissed the idea of codependency making up its own personality disorder category. One study found, though, that while codependent people do share some overlap with dependent personality disorder symptoms and borderline personality disorder symptoms, or shall we say traits, there are also people who exhibit codependency without exhibiting symptoms of dependent personality disorder or borderline personality disorder, which was found and concluded and put into fact, I guess one might say, by Napkick et al., and I might be mispronouncing that, in 2017 research. Codependency can be distinguished from dependent personality disorder because codependent people are dependent on a specific person or persons, but limited, while people with dependent personality disorder are dependent on others in general. Codependency can be distinguished from borderline personality disorder. While borderline personality disorder includes instability in interpersonal relationships, it does not involve, so they say, dependence on other people. But actually, for many people with borderline personality disorder, it can involve dependence on other people. So this was what this KNAPEC person et al. In a study said. However, not really entirely accurate because not all people with BPD are, not all are dependent on people, but many are. So they're not all the same. So just to sum up this, codependency is a psychological concept that refers to people who have extreme amounts of dependence on certain loved ones in their lives and who feel responsible for the feelings and actions of those loved ones. Codependency is not recognized as a distinct personality disorder by any version of the DSM, including the current one. And that said, research, they claim, shows that while codependency does overlap with other personality disorders, it does not appear to constitute a distinct psychological construct. And in that way, the word usage means a distinct psychological or distinct personality disorder. The best way to learn about codependency is to review the signs of codependency to get hopefully as accurate information as you can. There are some wonderful sources out there. Then there are sources who are more interested in it in calling it a personality disorder, even though it isn't formally that at all. And then there's still a lot of people that talk out there about or write about codependency in the really old definition of it. And that isn't really helpful to people today either, who really want to understand what codependency is about. And on this channel and in my podcast, which you'll see some episodes coming on this channel, codependency, inside out, in depth, because it's complicated. It's a mental health issue. It's been left in a no man's limbo, and that's not helpful to people. And the number one challenge for people with codependency is to be able to become aware that they have codependency, because the number one defense is denial that they have codependency. So if you're wondering if you have codependency, but see, a lot of people think codependency really has a negative connotation. They think that codependency means that you're to blame for what happens to you. That's not true at all. Let me make that clear, please. That people with codependency can be really hurt by people with borderline personality, narcissistic personality, so can other people. But most people that get in these relationships and really suffer tremendously have codependency. And they might be denying that and or unaware of that. But when I tell you that that's likely the case, and if this is the first time you're hearing it, please know there's no blame attached to it. Because nobody, if you've been in a relationship with somebody with another personality disorder, specifically cluster B or other mental health challenges, and you have codependency from adverse childhood experience and family of origin, which you need to get into a healing recovery process for, which I'm out here to work with you if I resonate with you, then the thing is, please hear this clearly. There's no way that people with codependency are to blame for how they are treated and why it's so difficult to leave the kind of situationships, unhealthy relationships that people with codependency often find themselves getting into. That's not your fault. You're not to blame for that. You might have some responsibility in learning more about that to help yourself out and to heal, but you are never responsible for somebody else's treating you poorly or beyond poorly. And I want to make that really clear. So that's just a little bit about what can be confusing about the mental health challenge that is a construct of a painful, formidable mental health challenge called codependency that's been left in limbo with, you know, it overlaps with BPD, it overlaps with dependent personality disorder. What does that mean? Well, please hear me when I say it doesn't mean that if you have codependency, you have borderline personality disorder. It doesn't mean if you have codependency, you have dependent personality disorder. And there are people with borderline personality disorder do also have codependency. And it's been pretty much, I think, made known out there that people with narcissistic personality disorder also have codependency. I'm not so sure that I agree that malignant narcissists or overt grandiose narcissists have codependent personality disorder. That's been forwarded out there under the explanation that narcissists are dependent upon supply. But see, dependency isn't codependency. So I don't agree with that part. But in the covert, more fragile, vulnerable narcissist, which isn't even a diagnosis, the fragile, vulnerable part, they often, and I've worked with many clients like this, they do have codependency as well. But then the codependency that I'm here to talk to you about the most, though, that if it resonates with you, is the codependency that means you don't have borderline personality disorder and you don't have dependent personality disorder and you're not a narcissist. You have codependency. And that is not only a construct, psychological construct, it is actually a mental health challenge, though it be not called a personality disorder, which I think is a wonderful thing. But people with codependency do need healing and recovery processes and often will go through very painful relationships in their adulthood, maybe a series of them, maybe a couple of them, before they come to realize that they may well be codependent. So if you think that you resonate or you know that you resonate with codependency, please know that's not blaming you for anything, that it happened to you from adverse childhood experience, and that if you get into a healing and recovery journey working with someone, and like I said, if you resonate with me, I'm out here to work with you, there's no blame. It's not about blame. People with codependency carry a lot of guilt and shame and other kind of wounds that get replayed and replayed, and you might feel terrible for the slightest thing that you think you did or for how somebody else feels. But those things are really not your responsibility. And you need to get to know you better, and you need to know what created the codependency for you in your life. So I hope that was a little bit helpful or some food for thought. And it's just a beginning, and we're going to really get into this over here, hopefully in ways that will help many, many people. And yes, I am available for one-to-one sessions, and you can find how to purchase and book sessions with me if I resonate with you at ajmahari.ca. And as always, take care.
Thank you for listening to the Codependency Inside Out podcast with your host, counselor, and trauma recovery coach, AJ Mahari. You may want to also subscribe to the Codependency Inside Out YouTube channel at youtube.com/user/AJM Mahari. And if you would like to work with AJ on your codependency recovery journey, please visit ajmahari.ca.